Riding on track for the first time is one of the most exciting, rewarding things you can do on two wheels, and a chance to see what your bike can really do. And the question we get asked the most at MCN is, how exactly do you do it? Find out, we're here today at Anglesey Circuit with my good friend and MCN colleague, Gareth. Now, Gareth is a new rider that hasn't been on track before, and today we're gonna teach him how to do it. So tell me a little bit about your riding experience, Gareth.
I've got just 2 years of road riding experience, done a couple of track days in a car, but I've never been near a circuit on a bike. I'm really keen to see what it's all about.
So before we get going, we're gonna need a motorbike. You can use any bike you want on the track day, but my advice would be is not to ride something too slow because the closing speed is a little bit dangerous. Today, we have got a couple of beautiful Ducatis, and it's a nice progression actually. We've got a Ducati 950S Supersport, and we've got the all-singing Ducati V4 Panigale. Now, the Supersport is a great bike to kind of learn your track craft on. A super bike is very, very fast, handles amazingly. So if you're gonna start on track day, something a little bit low powered like the Supersport, it's still fast, got lots of electronics. The S model here has got O-rings on it. It handles fantastically well. And it's just an easy bike to ride. It's a V-twin, it's quite roomy, nice and docile. So it's the perfect kind of start really for you, Gareth. And then obviously when you progress, then you can go down the superbike route. This V4 has got well over 200 bhp, you know, MotoGP riders use this as their practice bikes in between races. So a superbike really is the ultimate track day bike. Next thing you're gonna need is some good quality riding kit, just like Gareth's. So what are you wearing there?
I've got hold of RST's latest V4.1 airbag suit, and I've also got some TrackTech Evo boots and gloves.
Perfect, airbags are the way forward. And finally, the other big thing you need for a track day is good tyres. Now, I've been to a lot of track days and seen some very odd choices out there. You don't really want to go down the sports touring tyre route, although they're perfectly good. And equally, you don't really want to go down the full race tyre route where you need tyre warmers, you need the correct compound for the conditions. You're best off on tyres like these, sports tyres or track day tyres. So on the Supersport, we've got Pirelli Diablo Rosso 4 tyres. These are their latest all-round sports tyres. So these are really, really good on the road. They're triple compound at the rear, dual compound at the front. They warm up really quick. They've got loads and loads of grip. And really for today's sessions, these are gonna be absolutely perfect. Really, really easy to manage. And then when you progress through your track day journey, you're gonna need more track-orientated tyres. So these are Pirelli Diablo Supercorsa SP tyres. Near as damn it as fast as a proper race tyres, but they don't need tyre warmers. They warm up relatively quickly in race tyre world, not quite as fast as these, but these have obviously got the ultimate grip. The other thing to bear in mind is tyre pressures. Now this is a really interesting one. So tyres are designed to work at their recommended pressures. They're designed to have a certain profile. On the road, recommended pressures will give you your correct profile. As soon as you go on track and you put more heat through the tyres when you work them hard, then the tyres grow. So then you're gonna need to let the pressures down for the track. If you don't, when the tyres grow, then your contact patch shrinks. So rather than have a palm's worth of rubber on the road, you've got like a thumbprint's worth of rubber on the road. So dropping the pressures for the track is essential, but you have to remember to put them back to road pressures when you're finished. So with all that covered, let us begin.
Let's go.
first things first, let's get out on track. Let's learn the bike. Let's learn the circuit. I'm going to lead you out. If you just follow me around the track, maybe four or five bike lengths behind, just go where I go, follow my line. Don't worry about gears, don't worry about body position, just ride at your own pace. I'll come and ride at your pace. And what we've also done with this bike is set the riding modes in quite a safe mode. So it's in touring mode to begin with. So you've got nice docile power, you've got a lot of traction control, you've got a lot of ABS intervention, you've got a lot of wheelie control. So the bike would just be piece of cake to ride to begin with. And then as the sessions go through, we can kind of release the electronics and let you have a bit more fun.
Sounds brilliant to me. Let's go.
That was our first session. That was the perfect opportunity for us to look around the track, see the shape of the corners. So the big question is, how was that for you? First time on track, first time on this bike.
Blimey, there's a lot to take in, isn't there? What an amazing circuit, and it's so good to be on a bike, but I can see just by looking at you, I've got so much to learn. I'm surprised that the amount of, I'm using much fewer gears than I was expecting to use. I'm really keen to learn more now.
How's it differ from the road riding?
That you use all the space available, don't you? So that's a big shift. You're not trying to avoid oncoming vehicles. You're not really thinking about people pulling out on you from junctions and the like. It's more about concentrating on you and the circuit. And there's so much to learn there.
And enjoying the bikes.
Yeah, and enjoy the bikes, of course.
What we did then was just to go out and learn the bikes, learn the track. And it's a really good thing when you're going to a track for the first time, you haven't been to one for a while, is just take that first session opportunity of just going steady and looking at the shape of the track, you know, turning your head and look around, because it's very easy to get tunnel vision and the track turns into a bunch of alleyways and you don't ever really know what the shape is. And if you know what the shape is before you get to a corner, then it's much easier to attack. So I can see that we've got a little bit of room for improvement, which is what everyone goes through when they go from the road to the track. So the two things we're going to talk about now is gear position and body position. So let's talk about gears. What gears were you in when we were out just now?
Well, I'm third through here. Uh-huh. I'm still in third through here.
Yeah.
I'm keeping it in third round here, and I'm snatching fourth after this church corner here. And then cruising up here. I have caught fifth a few times up here. And then I'm dropping it down to third for this really tight section here and then staying in third basically all the way around again. So yeah, I'm not using hardly any gears.
I can see why you're doing that. It's a nice, comfortable way of riding and it's what most riders do when they go on the track, using lazy gears really. And so the bike's nice and smooth. It's not too violent. But really on circuit, we want the engine to work with us a little bit more just for safety. And using the high gears at low revs around these tight corners is fine, but it can lead to a few problems. In the middle of a tight corner, if you're too low down in the revs, then you're right before the bike's hitting its peak torque, and that's the point where it's very easy to spin a tyre. Now, with traction control, that's not really going to cause you any problems, but you don't want to be bumping into the electronics anyway, and you want to be using the bike to your advantage. So for the tighter corners, you really want to be using lower gears. That's going to be a benefit in many ways. It's going to help you stop for the corner easier because you've got lots of engine braking. It's going to help you keep a nice tight line. It's going to give you maximum acceleration coming out. And if the wheel does spin, it hasn't got many revs left so it fizzles out to the red line. So you've got your own inbuilt traction control anyway.
Very clever.
So I would say the gears you're using on the fast sections are perfect. But on the tighter corners, we just need to pull it back a gear.
Okay, cool.
One thing nearly all road riders do when they go on the track is not move around on the bike, because you don't really need to on the road. But on the track, it's essential. Being in the right body position and basically hanging off in the corners is going to give you a load of advantages. It's going to stop you leaning over too far. It's going to give you more feel for the bike. It's going to give you more front end grip. It's going to make you feel more connected. So let's split the body position up into two sections. We'll talk about our bottom half and our top half. So we'll talk about our bottom half first. First of all, we'll think about the foot position. So if I'm leaning around a left-hand corner, my outside foot can be flat on the pegs, like Daffy Duck or Charlie Chaplin. And the inside foot, my toe's wedged up against the frame rails, and the ball of my foot is on the foot peg. So that's my foot position there. My right leg, or outside leg, is gripping onto the tank. So I don't actually need to be hanging on here. It's all about keeping yourself loose and floppy. And my inside leg, my knee is just pointing straight on. You don't have to go reaching out for the ground. That will happen naturally. You'll get your knee down naturally with the right body position. So that's our bottom half. Then the top half, when you're in the middle of the corner, is all about being low on the bike. It's like riding the bike like a racehorse. So you should feel the fuel tank on your chest. And the only way to get there is to lean forward. So you're leaning forward here. You've got your inside arm bent, so your elbow's pointing towards the ground. So most road riders, as you were in the first session, were riding with your inside arm really, really straight. And you were Charlie Chaplin on both foot pegs. So we're neating that up. So the inside arm's pointing at the floor. It's floppy. And the outside arm is more or less straight. And then your head and shoulders are down where this mirror is. It's down to the side of the screen. If you haven't got mirrors, it's kind of, you know, your chin is near your hand there. And that is your mid-corner body position. And with this body position, you've got lots of weight over the front tyre, so you can feel what's going on. You've got more grip, and you've got the bike more upright in the corner. So you've got more ground clearance, and you're riding on the fatter bit of the tyre, and everything's safer. The other crucial thing to remember is when to get in and out of your body position. So it's always good to get into your bottom half of your body position while there's no real load on the motorbike. So that's generally down the straights before the braking zone. So on any given corner, before I come up to the corner, I get myself into my bottom half body position. I can still keep my top half inside the bike. And then when it's time to brake, I'm now hanging on with my outside leg and my thigh. And then when it's time to go into the corner, I'm letting go of the brake, and then I'm getting my head and shoulders off to the side. And then coming out of the corner, it's essential to remember not to get back on the bike too soon. A lot of people get straight back on the bike while they're still in the corner, and basically what they're doing is pushing the bike down as they're getting on the throttle. So they're leaning the bike over as they're getting on the throttle, and then you're going to get in all sorts of problems. So what that means in essence, around most racetracks, haven't got a straight long enough for you to really get back on the seat and kind of get tucked in like you would do on a 125 or a Moto 3 bike. So you're always hanging off one way or the other, anticipating the next corner. So I'm going to let you jump on and see how you look. So let's get into our bottom part of the body position. So foot peg position first. So outside foot is Charlie Chaplin. Inside foot, the balls of your toes on the foot pegs. And you should be able to just hang on with your outside thigh. So how's that feel?
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Odd.
Odd, but
odd
brilliant.
Compared
yeah.
to your road riding position.
Absolutely, yeah.
So now the top half of your body. So is your inside arm's bent with your elbow nice and loose, aiming at the floor. Outside arm is straight. And obviously you're looking around the left-hand corner there. And you've got your chest on the tank. So you're always low all the time, unless you're braking. That's the key. So how does that feel?
It's good. It's slightly unsettling. I need to go and try it on track, you know?
Yeah, let's go and do it then.
Yeah, yeah, cool.
we've been out and done gears and body position. Talk about gears first. Do they help?
Massively, yeah. I really felt like I was in a much better position with the bike. Not in terms of body position, but in terms of being able to get on the throttle and just keep the bike where the bike was supposed to be. You know, it doesn't want to run on, like you say.
Really helps it keep aligned, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And in body position, that looked really, really different. That looked really good.
That's the thing. That's the transformative thing about what you've just taught me. I feel like I'm with the bike now, rather than trying to fight against it. That's an incredible difference. Amazing.
Yeah. The Rome wasn't built in a day. You've just had one session doing that. You've still got a long way to go. You've got to remember to keep your inside toe on the pegs and really hang off. Hang off like you mean it. In your mind's eye, be Marquez. That's how you should kind of think. And also, coming away from today, if you forget everything else, bending your inside arm in the corner and having your toe on the peg, even on the road where you don't actually hang off, just makes such a huge difference to your bike control and the way you feel on the bike. So that's a big tick. The next thing we're going to do is talk about corner entry and braking. Braking technique on the track, mainly using the front brake. We won't talk about back brakes now. That's a bit of more of an advanced kind of skill. But the general theme is just to be smooth. So when you're on the straights, you're on the throttle, it's time to brake. It's all about rolling off the throttle and just taking up the slack of the brake straight away. There shouldn't be any freewheeling between throttle and brakes because that kind of just wastes time. So it's one smooth action from throttle to the brakes, let the weight transfer onto the front of the bike, and then you can really squeeze the brakes hard. I mean, really, really hard. And of course, these bikes have got ABS as well, so there's no chance that they'll ever fold, even going around corners, because they've got gyros that stop them as well. So once you've got the weight over the front wheel, you can really pull for your life. Okay. And then this is the big one. The thing that really separates road riders from experienced track riders is corner entry, and it's off throttle turning. So where a road rider would probably brake at the same time as a racer on the track, what a road rider would do was get straight back on the throttle and power through the corner. And that's what you need to do on the road, because if you are faced with an obstacle or danger, gravel on the road, then you can come off the throttle and then slow down and steer around it, and it's nice and safe. You don't need to do that on the track. If you adopt that approach on the track, you can go fast, but you'll get to a point where you're going too fast in the middle of the corner, and then you can't get on the throttle hard enough on the way out. You're stressing the tires, the bike feels aggressive, loose, and it's quite a stressful way of riding. What a racer would be to brake at the same time as a road rider, but they wouldn't touch the throttle until they're at the apex of the corner. So effectively, you're freewheeling from the time you release the brakes to the time you get to the apex, or even just past.
Right, okay.
And that's got many advantages. The bike will steer nice and easy because you're not interrupting it with throttle.
Yeah.
You'll be able to hold a nice tight line. You'll have more ground clearance because there's no weight transfer on the back when you're on the throttle. Mm-hmm. The tires are gripping more. And because you've turned through the corner so tight, you can then lift the bike up and use full throttle down the straights,
yeah,
while the road rider is still collecting it all up on the throttle. So when we go out next time, I want you to brake at the same time. I don't want you to scare yourself by braking any later, but I don't want you to touch the throttle again until you're at the apex.
Okay.
And to begin with, you'll find that you won't be able to reach it.
Right.
You'll have to accelerate back up to it again.
Okay.
So as the laps unfold, corner by corner, the way to get to what we want to do is just to bleed the brakes off a little bit sooner each time, just so you've got more and more momentum going into the corner.
Yeah.
And eventually you'll be able to get to the corner off the throttle.
Mm-hmm.
Once we're a few laps in, to demonstrate that, I'll take my right hand off the bar.
Really?
Just to show you that I'm not actually doing anything in the corner.
Okay.
And so the bike will be running in just on momentum. And of course, racers don't do that really, because they're braking all the way up to the corner, which we're not going to be doing today. We're just going to kind of just bleed the brakes in maybe halfway to half lean and then let go of them completely. But they'll be doing exactly what we need to do. They won't be touching the throttle until the apex. If you're accelerating before that, you've kind of got it wrong.
Yeah.
You're going in a little bit too slow. When we go out, we're going to practice that, keep going with the body position. You've got your gears set. One final thing we'll do before you go out, now that you're up to speed, is we'll adjust the electronics. So we'll put the bike in sport mode.
Okay.
So that's going to give you less intrusion from the traction control, less intrusion from the wheelie control, a little less intrusion from the ABS. You've still got that safety blanket there, but the bike's going to be a little bit more responsive in your hands as well, and a little bit more fun.
Blimey, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's cool. go and do it.
All right.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Good fun.
Right, so we were out there looking at braking, transition from throttle to brakes. That was really, really good. How did that feel?
It felt faster. It definitely felt faster. It yeah. felt less kind of controlled in a way, but definitely, definitely faster. You could notice how fast, much yeah. faster it was, yeah.
And then the off-throttle turning.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the big kind of eureka moment for a lot of road riders.
Yeah, it is. You can just, the confidence you've got that you can carry so much more speed through yeah. that apex, yeah, yeah, it really does help. And you're not, it's difficult to train yourself not to jump on that throttle and just exactly. try and power on through, but actually it makes such a difference because, like you say, when you brake, you nibble into the corner and then yeah. you're going a lot further, you're a lot faster out.
And all those other things we've done leading up to this has helped that. So the very fact that you're leaning more forward over the bike now gives you the confidence just to be off throttle, so you know you're planted. The lower gears helps you stop. You know, if you'd have been using the taller gears, you wouldn't have been able to do that so much. So that all pieces together beautifully. So there's one more thing now. So we've got corner entry sorted. We need to think about what we do coming out the corners. Now that you're off throttle cornering, you've hit the apexes nicely, now it's time to accelerate. So one thing you need to look out for is where to accelerate to.
Right.
You know, rather than accelerating out into no man's land, especially when you start to progress to a bigger bike, you don't quite know how far to open the throttle. You need to aim towards something. Luckily, most racetracks, Anglesey included, have got exit curbs. And the general rule of thumb is that as soon as you're through the apex and you're looking down the track, is to look out for where the curb runs out on the exit.
Sure.
And that's what you're accelerating to. Okay. So for almost every corner here, that applies. There are some corners where you're deliberately not using all the track coming out of one corner because you need to set yourself up for another one.
Yeah.
But as a general rule of thumb, the exit curbs are the thing to go for. Once you get to that exit curb end, you should be pretty much fully upright. So then you need to train yourself just to, even if it's for a split second, just to get the throttle to the stop. Quite often you'll accelerate through the gears and it will rev out to the red line, but you'll not actually got the throttle to the stop.
Okay.
So if you train yourself just to go click, click, you know, just on some of the straights to begin with, you'll start to realize that the bike doesn't actually, you know, leap out of your hands, but it will make it go a little bit faster and you'll see your lap time start to drop.
Okay, cool.
So this is the final session. That's the final thing to do. All the rest of the little tips and tricks are kind of polishing the diamond, and that's going to take the rest of your life to do.
Oh, yeah.
So let's talk about corner exit, and let's go and give it a go. So before we go out and do this final drill, is there anything that we need to just polish up on before we leave?
Well, there
the
is
pits?
Something. I'm not sure if it's a problem or not, really, but I noticed, particularly in some of the slower speed corners, my right toe, regardless of where it is on the peg, it's hitting the ground.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if that makes me a hero or zero, really. Well, but what's that all about?
Well, it feels nice, doesn't it?
Yeah.
But that is a surefire sign. If you're getting your toe down or your pegs down, you haven't got the correct body position. Your upper body isn't hanging off the bike enough.
Right.
So when we go out again, just remember the first thing we did. Push the bike away from you in the middle of the corner. Keep your elbows bent. Uh-huh. hang your bum right off the seat, yeah, and then you won't have any problems with ground clearance.
Yeah, I built up a sweat in that one, but it sounds like I need to be even more physical this
exactly,
time.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool, okay. Well, right, let's give it a go.
Yeah. Outstanding.
You're telling me, it was brilliant fun.
Your body position, your top half of your body's position was brilliant. I mean, you were like Marquez, I was lying earlier. How did it feel?
I felt like my elbow and the whole upper half of my body was going really close to the track, but the result was phenomenal because you felt so much more in control. The bike is completely solid underneath you. It feels like you're leaning really that far over, but you're really not. Actually, I can feel I'm leaning less because I'm kind of pushing the bike away. The upper body is going into the corner. And because of that, the corner speeds are so much higher, but it's just more stable as well.
Exactly. How did you get on with the corner exit, looking for the markers at the edge of the track?
It had its ups and downs, to be honest with you. I think I nailed a few of them, but there were a few where I felt like I was either running a little bit too wide, not getting far enough up the curb, or indeed just taking the corner a little bit too tight and going too far up the road, you know. But that's practice, you know.
Exactly. Yeah. This is just the start of your journey now, isn't it? And yeah, you need to do more practice, getting the bottom half of your body off a little bit more, the off-throttle cornering, just perfect a little bit more because you're carrying a little bit too much corner speed. But apart from that, absolutely brilliant. How was the bike in the end? Did you bump into the electronics or anything like that?
Electronics, no. I did use full throttle enough, I think, as you suggested. I saw the dash flashing quite a few times, yeah, indicating I'm doing it properly. But mega bike. I mean, I love the way I love the flexibility of that engine because it slows down really nicely off the throttle, you know. So yeah, it really comes to you. It doesn't feel like it's really highly strung, which is something. I didn't really know what to expect from a bike like this, but yeah.
Easy bike to ride.
Yeah, really.
And how about the gears and the quick shifter? Did you use those?
First time I've ever used a quick shifter. I figured it out on my own. And that takes a bit of the thinking out of the equation as well, doesn't it? So nice touch. I think if I was buying a bike today, I'd have to buy one with a quick shifter.
Yeah. Well, we've gone through all these different stages and they've all aiming towards one thing really. And it's the secret of track riding. And it's to do everything, all your work along the straights. You don't need to be the last of the late breakers to go fast. You don't need massive corner speed to go fast. It's all a question of just getting through the corners nice and neatly and then using these bike superpowers down the straights. You know, these are both powerful motorbikes. If you're going too fast in the middle of the corners, you can't use what they've got down the straights. And also your body position is really, really crucial, like we spoke about earlier, to stop you leaning over so far, which you've mastered almost, which is fantastic. So any final thoughts from you?
Yeah, where's the next one?
How long we got? Well, thank you for today. I've really, really enjoyed it. I hope you've learned a little bit.
Huge amount. Thank you so much, Neevesy. It's been great to learn from a star like you.
No problem. Well, I don't know about that, but I hope you've got something out of this video as well. You know, if you're a road rider going on track for the first time, if you've got a little bit of track day experience, those kind of four elements really are really going to help you build your confidence, your bike control. And then after that, it's just little tiny little bits and bobs here and there, but they're the fundamentals. So thanks for watching and we'll see you soon.